Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. My name is Sarah Guillemard. I am the MLA for Fort Richmond. I am pleased to be here today as the province of Manitoba announces some exciting news that will be a significant impact on our community. I'd like to begin by acknowledging that the University of Manitoba campuses are located on the original lands of the Anishinaabe, Cree, Oji-Cree, Dakota, and Dene peoples, and on the homeland of the Métis Nation. We respect the treaties that were made on these territories. We acknowledge the harms and mistakes of the past, and we dedicate ourselves to move forward in partnership with Indigenous communities in a spirit of reconciliation and collaboration. I would like to take this opportunity to acknowledge our speakers today. The Honorable Kelvin Goertzen, Minister of Education and Training, Mr. John Kearsey, Vice President External, University of Manitoba, Dr. Gady Jacoby, Dean of the Asper School of Business and CPA Manitoba Chair in Business Leadership here at the University of Manitoba, Suzanne Gagnon, Director of the James W. Burns Leadership Institute and the Canada Life Chair in Leadership Education. I would now like to invite U of M alumnus, the Honorable Kelvin Goertzen, to share details of an important investment by the province to support our leaders of tomorrow.
Thank you very much, Sarah. It's always a pleasure to be with Sarah. Tremendous MLA, not just for this area, but for the province of Manitoba. And I've enjoyed serving with her over the last 3.5 years and look forward to serving with you for many more years, although who knows how many years I have left. I know you have many left. I appreciate very much the opportunity to be back on campus for this important announcement. I thank you for the invitation, John and Dr. Jacoby, Dr. Gagnon. It's a pleasure to be with each of you today. Leadership is an interesting concept and it's an interesting skill. It's sometimes difficult to define and it's difficult to put into words, although many books have been written about leadership, and I've read many of them and studied a little bit when I was at the Faculty of Management, as it was called, when I was in the faculty. In government, I've learned that leadership skills come in many different ways, and they come in many different varieties, and they come from many different kinds of people. And their experiences are what make them ultimately good leaders. We talk about people who are born with leadership skills, and while there might be some degree of truth to that, it really is experiential. And as you go through different things in your life, you learn to be a better leader, and you learn through that experience. So reading in books is important, and reading the experiences of others is important. But we are really blessed in Manitoba, and I don't think we trumpet this enough, to have some great leaders in our own midst, in our own province, tremendous international leaders. And the Leadership Institute can tap into those individuals and to bring people from across the faculties here at the University of Manitoba and to allow them to learn from those leaders very directly and very personally. Because ultimately, those experiences were meant to be shared, and they can be shared, they can be utilized more quickly from those who are learning from them. So the Leadership Institute, which we are pleased to now be investing $2.5 million into over the next 10 years, I think serves a number of different purposes. I'm really excited by the fact that it allows people from other than the faculty of, or the Asper School of Business, as it's now called, to be enrolled in. It's really important that it brings in people from other faculties, whether you are a leader in healthcare or in social services or a number of different disciplines. Leadership is really, really important. It's not exclusive to management. It's not exclusive to business. So the Leadership Institute, I think, is a wonderful, wonderful opportunity to provide leadership instruction and leadership principles to people from across our different faculties and our different disciplines. It's also really important because we know that the future of Manitoba is based on that leadership. And that leadership isn't just innate, it is something that has to be experienced, and it is something that has to be learned, and it should have its own sort of focus. And so the focus that the Leadership Institute puts on it I think will be a great value for those who have the opportunity to participate. I understand that the first class is already underway now, and I look forward to hearing the results of that, but more importantly, in the years ahead, 10, 20, 30 years down the road, I really look forward to seeing the results of it and the leaders that have come from that institute. And as they gather as alumni, as I'm fortunate to come as alumni now from the University of Manitoba, but as the alumni of that leadership institute and the various classes that graduate from it come together in the years in the future, it'll be amazing to see the leadership that they provided, hopefully to Manitoba, but wherever they go, in Canada or the world, and the difference that they've made as a result of that. So thank you very much. We are pleased as a government to be a part of the Leadership Institute, but we're most pleased and most proud of each of you who are involved in making it happen and are being ensuring that the future leaders of Manitoba are well-trained so that all of us can be well-served. Thank you very much for the opportunity to be here.
Thank you, Minister Goertzen, and I have definitely benefited from being mentioned under your leadership. I now invite Mr. John Kearsey to provide remarks on behalf of the University of Manitoba.
Thank you. Thank you, Minister Goertzen, for being here with us on the campuses of the University of Manitoba this afternoon. On behalf of our President, David Bonnard, who's unable to be with us, and our campaign chair, Paul Soubry, as well as all of our faculty, staff, our students, and our alumni, we thank you for this investment in leadership at the University of Manitoba. Just last week, Paul Desmarais Jr. was here, and he announced the naming of the institute, the James W. Burns Leadership Institute, and that's because of an amazing investment of Power Corp, Canada Life, and IG Wealth Management and their staffs. This $2.5 million added to that really secures wonderful funding for the Leadership Institute and gives our students a real an upper hand in making a contribution to our province, to our country, and indeed to the world. So we thank you, as we are very excited about the leadership that's already been provided to our university. Our alumni around the world already have proven themselves to be incredible leaders. So I'm really keen to see what happens as our students get more of a intentional exposure to leadership through the curriculum, through the president's leadership program, through the research that we do. I think you're right. The 20, 30 years down the road from now, we're going to see really amazing impact from the James W. Burns Leadership Institute as we train and grow our leaders. So thank you. Your alma mater thanks you. The president thanks you. Our campaign chair, Paul Soubry, thanks you for taking your place today in this very, very important initiative. And we wish you well, and we ask you to thank your government colleagues, the premier, as well on behalf of the university. So thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Kearsey. I now invite Dean Jacoby to say a few words on behalf of the Asper School of Business.
So again, I would like to echo what John just said and to thank you for this generous investment that will make the Institute go forward and be successful. So thank you for that. So on behalf of the Asper School of Business, I would like to acknowledge this transformational investment that will help us cultivate leaders across all sectors. As you mentioned, not just business students, but students from all fields in all universities across Manitoba. And I would like to acknowledge those who will benefit directly from this investment, meaning our students, the first cohort of students in the President's Student Leadership Program, who are currently downtown on a site visit participating in the first week of the program. I want to personally offer my gratitude for the leadership of my colleague, Dr. Suzanne Gagnon, the director of the James W. Burns Leadership Institute and a Canada Life Chair in Leadership Education. She's truly an inspiring leader to the students in the program. So thank you for that. And finally, I would like to acknowledge the guidance and perspectives that we receive from the Institute's Senior Executive Council and Advisory Board. This is truly an exciting moment for an opportunity for the Asper School, for our university, and for our province. So again, thank you for that. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dean Jacoby. I would now like to invite Suzanne Gagnon to tell us about the impact that this funding will have on the James W. Burns Leadership Institute.
Thank you very much, Sarah. Wonderful to be here. Welcome to Minister Goertzen. Thank you for being here as well. Good afternoon, everyone. So it has been my great pleasure to serve as the inaugural Canada Life Chair in Leadership Education here at the University of Manitoba and the director for the newly named James W. Burns Leadership Institute since this past November. The past 7 months have been a whirlwind of activity as we've created our new programming, including the President's Student Leadership Program. And some of you in the room were extremely helpful and instrumental working with us in partnership to create that program, which I do believe is unique across the country in bringing together students from every discipline of study, from engineering to nursing to education, architecture, business, social work, the arts, science. It's truly very exciting. The program has also welcomed students from our other post-secondary schools here in the province, including for this year, our pilot year, University College of the North, University of Winnipeg, and Red River College, as well as the University of Manitoba. So not long after I arrived in Winnipeg, we announced the start of this program. We've also been working very much with other faculties and deans and co-curricular leaders here at the university to create other types of programming that will reach into the student body as far as we can. And we're very pleased about that as well. So the students this year cross backgrounds, interests, disciplines, and also levels of study. And really the vision, a strong part of the vision behind the Institute is that to lead, you need to collaborate. And collaborating across differences, across diversity, across walks of life, across interests is critical for our society. This morning we were at the United Way and we had a wonderful talk from the CEO, Connie Walker. And the students, I'm happy to also announce, will all be involved in community projects in the coming year. And they're using United Way data and other sources of inspiration. The top leaders, as Minister Goertzen mentioned, who will be meeting with this week and in the fall, to really shape these projects as bringing something new to our community. So while these are students who are working on their careers and we want to build their skills and their strengths for the future of the province and the country, they are also servants to the province and the country, and they were chosen in large part because of their existing collaborative approach to leadership, which they had to show through their experience. So thank you for your comment about leadership being experiential. I firmly believe that. It's a journey of continuous learning, so we really hope to set these students and others who will benefit from this great gift and from our programming in the future to really contribute well in the future. So I'd like to thank the province for their support of the Institute and the significant investment in developing the future leaders of Manitoba. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Ms. Gagnon. This concludes the formal portion of this program. I would like to invite media to direct any questions to individual speakers following the event. Thank you. Merci. Miigwech.